Did you know that Oral-B stands for oral brush? No? Well, now you know. Well, this is one of the cheapest. It's the Oral-B Vitality. After 7 years of usage, the battery is wearing off. It isn't an expensive buy to get a new one, but I'm just curious if I can repair it myself. The repair looks quite daunting. And these are some of the tools that I use. Some pair of pliers. And I also bought a cheap soldering iron kit. You can just twist the head off. Don't pull like me. It's quite disgusting what has been built up in there. So a quick clean first. And this is the entire brush. I think you need to desolder these 3 or 4 points. What I'm using here is a desoldering lint. You can heat up the soldering lint on top of the solder and it will suck off the tin. It doesn't work that well at first. I think my iron is not hot enough. So let me switch to a bigger one. Bigger tip. Yes, this works like a charm. Yeah, there's a big blob of tin on this one. So that should do it. I think now you can remove at least the motor by removing the cap first. And the motor should come right out. There you go. I'm lifting the PCB up a bit because there's a little pin here that holds it together. And these two clips, I'm pushing them in so I can slide the battery out. Well, probably it was much easier to desolder the battery fully. Yeah. This time I want to use a solder vacuum. It came with my kit. Never used it before, so let's see how this works. Still using the big tip. Okay, that works surprisingly well. Got almost everything out. Now we can remove the battery. The original battery in the brush seems to be a little bit shorter and it has soldering tips. Yeah, you can see them here side by side. It is a little bit shorter and thinner. So I hope it fits into the compartment. Yeah, the width fits, but the length is a little bit longer. I'm reusing the soldering tips by removing them with a pair of small pliers. Yeah, I haven't done this before, but I think it's better to sand the tips a little bit to have a little bit more surface for the solder to attach. I don't know if you need to use flux, but I did. So first I'm going to apply a little bit of tin to the battery itself. I'm still using the bigger soldering tip. From what I have read, you use the bigger tip so you don't have to apply heat to the battery that much. Otherwise, the battery will overheat. And then we attach the lips to the tips. Well, it's surprisingly sturdy with just normal soldering tin. And I will do the bottom side as well. Just make sure that the tips align. Yeah, I know. It doesn't look that neat, but well, it holds. So let's try to fit the battery into the compartment. Well, it kind of fits. But we will see when we attach the PCB if everything aligns. And the most important thing is that a little plastic knob will align into the PCB. And it does. Nice. Yeah. I'm good with this. Yeah, it seems to do so. So let's reassemble the motor and resolder everything into place. Okay. It does nothing. Okay, after some research, I've read that you need to charge it for a bit to make the brush work again. So I decided to charge it overnight. And let's see what it does now. It works again. Perfect. I only use this brush when I go on vacation, because if it gets lost, I'm not worried too much about it. But if correct, then it should now have more than 3 times the capacity it had before. So probably you don't need to charge it for a few weeks.